Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is gateway in Power BI, when we need to use the gateway options in Power BI. We're exploring business scenario in our garments, and using this business, we are trying to understand how he can take the advantage of Power BI to enhance his business. Today, he got a question like, he wants to refresh the data in Power BI services from the Power BI file in a desktop. Meaning like he already deployed the report. If you are watching my playlist, just watch my previous videos. That this Nagamans has deployed the reports in Power BI services. Now he can able to access it. The underlying source for this report is like Excel that sits in his desktop. So now he wants to update the data in the Excel so that it will reflect in the Power BI services report. How to do that? In order to do that, he need a gateway. Let us see that in next slide to understand better about gateway. So we need a gateway if you are having a database or files or your underlying data sits in your on-premise server or your desktop, then you need a gateway from a cloud, I mean Power BI service, to contact your data and your on-premise. On-premise is nothing but your system, local system, or your internal server. That is called on-premise. So when we need a gateway, like this is the Power BI services that sits in the cloud, right? And we have a gateway here, that is your on-premise. In the on-premise, it is like a connector between your cloud and the underlying data in your on-premise. On-premise is your local system or service that you are internally maintaining. So if you are having your data in DB or files, then this gateway is like intermediate between. It has some mechanism securely transfer your data from your internal system to the cloud. That is what the gateway does it. So it maintains your credentials, all other things it maintains here. That is what it meant for. So there are two steps involved in it. First is to install a gateway on your local machine or on-premises system. Here we need to install the gateway. The second step is to schedule refresh on cloud so that whenever the data get updated in some frequency, you will get a scheduled refresh in the cloud, then your data get updated. So currently you are having data for today. Tomorrow, if this file is getting updated, then if you schedule a refresh, then the latest data will get reflected in your cloud report. We are going to see the first step in this video, that is installing a gateway. In my next video, we'll see schedule refresh in cloud. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. Let's jump into a demo. We are in Power BI service now. So how to download it? Just you can Google it using Power BI gateways. But easiest way is like go to this icon, that is download icon, where you can find the data gateway. Okay, that will lead you to directly to the gateway download link. One point to highlight here is like there are two modes, that is the standard mode and the personal mode. What are the difference? Let us see it here. Right, this is the standard mode and personal mode. So the standard mode is required for some reasons, like you need a direct query support or support for live connection. Basically it is for enterprise, that is organization level. You need to go for it, then use standard mode. If it is a personal mode, you need to download the personal gateway. There are two different gateways. Based on your requirement, you need to appropriately choose. In this case, I'm going for a personal mode since I'm going to show the demo in Excel, that is from my local. So let it download. Okay, now it got downloaded. Let us open it and try to install it. So just click on the double click on it. So you see here, like it is saying, getting ready to install on-premises data gateway, that is personal mode, and installation path. Just click on accept and install. That will so it is as quick as that. So it is now we have installed it. The thing is, like, installation was successful, and the email address to use this gateway. So this email address is for authenticating or logging in into this gateway. Okay, so I'm giving the user this gate logged in. Okay, this user can be a pro user or free user, anyone. So just giving the username once again and password. Okay, now we got that the gateway is online and ready to be used. Okay, now this is the thing we need to see. It is recommended to restart a gateway every time you make changes to the gateway configuration file. That's fine. In any changes done at that time, we need to use that one. Now it's fine. So the step one is complete, that we have installed it. Let us quickly go and check in our Power BI. So how to check it? So let us go to home, and let me go to my workspace and go to data sets, like over here, settings. Now you see here, it displays the personal gateway running on laptop, my laptop name, and it says like here, right? You can see it here. Let me zoom in. So running on my laptop, this is my personal gateway. Okay, that says the gateway is running. Now what about these two, like this customer text and v2.sales is the data source in my local system, so I need to edit it. Okay, so I need to specify Windows without impersonation privacy level. You say public or none, you say sign in using this user, that is whoever has. Now it got connected, it is connecting to my laptop. Okay, using this credentials that I provided. Now these two users have data now. So now we have successfully set up a gateway that will, from the cloud, that will connect to my local system the particular files. Okay, let us see refreshing this data in my next video. If you like this video, share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.